Hey everyone, Nick here again, and I want to show you how to make the most beautiful bar chart you've ever made before, and we're going to do it right inside of PowerPoint. You don't need to start in Excel and then copy and paste your data viz into PowerPoint. You can do it right inside PowerPoint right from the start. So here is a blank slide here, just one of the Microsoft's and PowerPoint's default slides. It's one of the content slides, and so right here in this content placeholder, you can click on any of these, but we're going to go ahead and click on the chart, insert chart, and right here, you get the menu of all the different charts that you can possibly use here. We're going to go ahead and just click on this horizontal bar chart here. I'm going to go ahead and click that and then click OK. The chart pops up, and then a little behind the scenes Excel document, an Excel workbook pops up, and this is where the data will live, or your source data. So I've already copied some survey data that I want to use in this regard right here, and actually I think I'm just going to paste it in right here. So this is my survey data. I'm going to label that there. I don't need these other two series, so I'm going to go ahead and just right click and click on delete, and then I can the first thing that I want to do is I can see here are my survey data. These are the showing top two box responses. So from, you know, like a Likert scale type survey here. So these are like fours and fives, the percentage of people who provided a four or five rating on each of these different items across my customer experience or satisfaction survey. The first thing that I want to do is I want to make sure the data here are sorted intentionally. And what I mean by that is, we want the data to be sorted greatest to least or least to greatest in some sort of intentional sort order so that our audience can really at a glance get the idea, what was the most, what was the least. You don't have to have your eye bouncing back and forth between the bars as it is right now, and that's one mistake that a lot of people make is maybe on your survey these items were ordered in a certain way and visitors rated their, you know, provided their ratings on your survey in that order, and that's how it exported in Excel. People often don't go that extra step to sort the data from greatest to least or least to greatest to help your audience understand the data a little bit easier, a little bit quicker when you're presenting it here. So let's go ahead and do that. And by doing that, all I need to do is highlight the entire area of this source data. I'm going to right click, and then we're going to go to sort right here. And then what I want to do is go to custom sort, and then make sure that we're sorting not by the, you know, alphabetically by the survey item, but by the actual data. So we're going to go ahead and say smallest to largest. When you say smallest to largest in the source data, that means that the bars will show up greatest to least on your slide. Excel is a little tricky in that way. They do things kind of backwards. So if you wanted it to, if you wanted your bars to be least to greatest, then you would just have to sort the source data greatest to least. So just push OK, and you'll see this nice sort order here from largest to smallest. We can close out of that Excel sheet then. Now there's a bunch of stuff that we want to do that's really nice best practice in DataViz design. One of the key pieces of DataViz design is to just declutter your slide and make things nice and clean and free of the things that are extraneous or extra. And we call that, you know, design clutter or you know, too much ink, whatever you want to call it, design ink. So what we're going to do here is we're going to get rid of the chart title. We don't need that because we have a nice space up here for a title on the slide. Then I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the legend here because we don't need a legend. There's no reason for it. I want to make sure that we have a nice condensed font here. So right now it's Calibri, which is the default. And when you have a condensed font, you'll be able to put a little bit more words into your slide, have a little bit more real estate to work with because the condensed font is a little bit squished. So the first condensed font that I kind of come across in my list here is this Arial Nova condensed. So let's go ahead and do that. I also want to update it to a nice darker shade. We're just going to do this black right here because we want people to be able to see the words on the slide. I'm going to increase the size up here at the font in the font menu. We're going to increase it. Right now it's defaulted to 12 points, but I want it to be probably about 16 or 18 points. So let's see what that looks like when I click up here. Let's see, 18 points. I think that looks really nice. I'm going to go ahead and click bold as well and make it bold. And then let's down here on the x-axis, let's also make that black, and then I'm going to change it to that condensed font too. All the text on my chart, I want to be that condensed font here. And I'm going to make sure it's that black. I don't know if we need it to be bold, but let's just go ahead and do it just in case. And then I'm going to make sure that increases. We'll increase that to 16. How about 18 again, too? It's probably a little big, but I'm going to show you a trick at the end here. We're actually just going to get rid of that x-axis, too. So let's just put it down to 16 for now. because maybe we do want that axis at some point. So the other thing I want to do is I want to decrease the width between the bars because these are really skinny right now. I want them to be nice and thick so that your eye has a lot of attention to be sort of drawn to each of these bars. And what you need to do here is highlight the bars by clicking on them, right click, and then click on Format Data Series. The Format Data Series menu will pop up here on the right. And if you go to this paint bucket here, this is where you can update things like colors, the border lines of the bars, things like that. Then if you click on this, this is where you could add things like shadow or glow effects. I totally recommend that you do not touch this menu for most of the time unless you're trying to do some things that are more artistic or stylized. But we're gonna edit the chart here over in this little bar chart icon. The series option, under this it says gap width, and this represents the gap between the bars. So we want that to be reduced as much as possible. And so you can just take this slider bar, if we went all the way down to zero, you would see like there's no gap width now, there's no gap between the bars. We probably want some gap, so let's go ahead and click on like 30% here. That looks pretty nice there, nice thick bars. And so look, our chart is already looking really nice. We want to put a nice title up here, and I'm going to go ahead and change the font to that nice condensed Arial Nova, and then maybe make it bold, and then let's actually change it so it's blue that represents the color of the bars. And what I'm going to say is something insightful about the data. So maybe we just say customers rated cleanliness highest and educational lowest. Now that's not, I guess, the most insightful title, but it's all I can come up with right now. So I'd probably sit for a little while and see what's the actual piece of data here that I want our readers or our audience to sort of know from this chart. And that's what I would put up here in the chart title there. Now it's looking pretty good. Now one of the things that we might want to do is put direct labels right on these bars. So all you have to do in order to do that is highlight the bars, right click, and then say add data labels right here. Once you do that, the labels pop up right outside the bar, and now you can edit them just like you edit any other text. So I'm going to go ahead and make that the nice Arial condensed. That's the nice thing there. Make it bold, maybe make it blue. And then let's type in, let's see, let's make that 16. Looks pretty nice there. One thing that I like doing, especially if there are the data bars are long enough, is to actually put that data label inside the end of the bar, because that's what's really encoding the data, right? Our eyes should go to the end of the bar. That end of the bar represents the data. In this case, that 90% at the top there, the 67% at the bottom. So let's go ahead and highlight those data labels and then go back over to the Format Data Label tab, that little bar chart icon right here, and then you can see under here the label position. It says you want to put it in the center, do you want to put it in the end, and that's where I want it. But you can see, of course, they're blue, so I can't see the label. So let's change the color of those labels to white. And that looks really nice. Now, when you label your data like this, there are a few things on the chart that are unnecessary. We don't need them anymore, and they don't serve any purpose because we're actually putting direct labels on each of those bars. That's what our eyes are going to be drawn to here. So we probably don't need the x-axis here at the bottom, and we definitely don't need the grid lines that kind of give us that visual estimation of where the data are. So I'm going to highlight the grid lines just by clicking on them, and I'm going to click backspace to delete them. And then we're going to go ahead and delete that x-axis there, and maybe I'll just reposition the chart just a little bit, make it a little bit bigger, and that looks so nice to the eye. Now I'm going to move this, let's see, we're going to actually, I think that's the only other thing. Oh, the other thing here is you can see this really faint grid line right here. That's actually not the grid line, that's our y-axis line, and in this case we probably don't even need that either. So I'm going to go ahead and click our y-axis, go over to the Format Axis menu there. And in that paint bucket, you can see the line menu right here. It's set to automatic, which is a very light gray. I'm just going to go ahead and say no line. And now we have absolutely no line there on the chart. So there's my steps for walking through creating the most beautiful bar chart you've ever seen in your slide. 90% of the data you present probably can be effectively presented with a bar chart. So if you just follow the steps in this video and you don't follow any other steps or don't learn anything new about data visualization, your charts and your slides will look beautiful when you're trying to present data. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. I appreciate all those likes. Hitting the bell to subscribe, each time I post a new tutorial, data design, Excel, PowerPoint, you'll get notified when those videos pop up. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.